Hey guys, so today I'm filming a video in response to the Luxy Hair Dream Giveaway Contest, and the contest is about what your biggest dream is and sharing it and sharing your plan on bringing your biggest dream to life. And I felt that it was something that was very related to my channel, kind of, because it's kind of like my journey and what I'm doing to make my dream come true. And I'm just going to warn you, I'm going to be looking at, like, the computer to make sure I'm getting everything down into this video. So, first of all, my biggest dream is to become a renowned fashion designer and open a series of boutiques around the world. I am 18 years old, and I'm still in high school. I graduated in May.
Yay!
And let's just... the first question is, other than what your biggest dream is why do you want this dream to come true? I've wanted to be a fashion designer since I was about 8 years old. It started off with me just drawing random outfits, and then I realized that what I'm doing could make a difference, and I just continued to work at it, experiment with colors and different styles. And then my mom taught me how to sew, and at first it started off with sewing patterns for Barbie doll clothes, and that was really fun, but I just wanted something bigger. So then it was baby dolls, and then by time I got to high school, I was like, I think I'm ready to make clothes for myself. So I took the apparel design class in my high school for my first year, and I mean, the rest is history. I've been working really hard at it. I've taken the class almost every single year. I work overtime to get things done. And this summer, I opened up my online store. On Etsy, it's jonesyj.etsy.com. I'll put the link below. And I also started a blog. It's a fashion / makeup / me, what I'm doing blog, like what I'm doing to make my dream come true. And I've always wanted to sell things that I've made, and I did kind of like a boutique sale on my high school campus, and I got some positive feedback, so I decided that I want to share what I'm doing with the world, you know? And I opened up an online store, and things have been pretty good. I'm constantly coming up with new ideas. I also participate in as many fashion shows as I possibly can, whether if I'm just an attendee or if I'm a designer in it. I participated in Scottsdale Fashion Week, and I did a redesign outfit, recycled outfit out of pennies, bubble wrap, tissue paper, and felt. Let me tell you, it was hard. It was really hard. And I'll post the link to the blog post in the info box. And that blog post has pictures of the outfit and some more details on it. And I went to Phoenix Fashion Week this past November, and that's what a lot of these blog posts is about, is my trip to Phoenix Fashion Week, all the people that I met, and all the great information that I got. And then in May, I'll be participating in a Japanese Comic-Con fashion show, and it'll be something different, you know, get me out of my box. But let's get back on track. So my goal is to open a boutique here in Arizona, but first things first, I've got to rent or lease out some studio space. So hopefully in the next 6 to 8 months, I'll have a studio space and somewhere near my home, preferably, but if not, I mean, what's a drive, you know? So, that is my next step is to rent some studio space, and then this board behind me, it's a board that I made last year. It's kind of like a dream board, and I highly recommend that anyone watching or anyone out there that has a dream, put it on paper. No, putting it on paper just... it's not fun. I make a board, make a collage, get magazine clippings, do whatever you need to do to make sure that your dream looks realistic and it feels like it's coming to life. Because I've made several business plans online with different software and all this other stuff, but it becomes tiresome and boring. I mean, all those details are great, but this here, this board is what makes dreams come true. So I'll just show you like this side of it first. And this is a dress that is a dress sketch, and this is what it's. I love flowers and I love geometric shapes that people don't use for store ideas. So this is what the price tags would look like in my store. They would be flowers like this with the ribbon attachment. And this is kind of like a rack setup of what the racks in the boutique would look like. And then I remove it from my face, and then you can see the general floor plan and how it's a hexagonal shape. Then you can kind of see, like, hopefully I'm not holding it too high, but you can see what my storefront would look like. I had the window cut out in the flower shape, and then the door with the nice framing on the outside, so if I get in here. And then these are shoe wheels. And eventually I do when I start designing shoes, but something that I can't really even fathom how to do that yet, but then I do design jewelry as well, and this is just more ways to sew shoes, and this is how I want my store to be. I want it to be really open and pretty, you know, pretty clean, not like sterile, but clean up to the point where it feels luxurious. You know how you walk into Nordstrom's and everything's just prim and proper? I want that kind of feeling in my store. And at this point in my life, I'm willing to do whatever I need to make this dream come true. Even if it comes to me, down to me being a college student, eating like a fourth of a package of Top Ramen each day to make this dream come true. It's what I need to do. I make a valiant effort to go to Los Angeles as much as I can, and I'll be going there in March to the Fabric District and to do the Finem fashion show and to see how that is and hopefully bring back some goodies so I can finish my spring clothing line. I have all the sketches. I'll maybe put them in the video towards the end, or I'll just link a blog post and I'll put all the sketches up on there. And you can see that I have a couple finished products, but I want to wait to launch the entire thing when I have a demo of each thing. And my spring collection is going to be a made-to-wear collection. I will have sizes and size chart on my both on my blog and on my Etsy storefront. And the thing I love about made-to-order sizes is that if I have a size listing in my size chart and that doesn't necessarily cater to your body, send me your measurements. I'll take it in where I need to take it in, let it out where I need to let it out. I have some curve-fitting designs, and then I have some that you want to fit snug in certain areas. Like, I'm designing a suit, and the pants are harem pants. You want them to fit as snug as possible on your waist so that they have that good flow outwards in the legs. And you want them to fit good on your ankles so that it gets really tight on your ankles and gives the balloon pant effect. And I feel like it's really important for women to know what it's like to have something that fits you perfectly. And I'm very flexible with everything, colors, and hopefully in my trip to LA I'll be able to bring back some swatches and share those with you guys as well. But I mean, fashion is my life, and this dream will come true. I mean, it's partially true already. I remember when I was little, I said I wanted to open a store of some sort, and an online store, if that's what it has to start out as, it's perfect for me. So check it out if you have any comments or questions on how I did do all of this. Or if you're interested in doing the same thing, I mean, I'm here to make my dream come true and anyone else's to come true as well. I really hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll post a bunch of links below, and hopefully I'll add some pictures into the video as well. We'll see how that goes, and then thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.